Hello, welcome to the lecture on state space analysis part 3. In this lecture, we are going to deal on controllability and observability of an system. Welcome to the lecture. Before going into the lecture, I want to look at these two circuits and I want to find what is the relation between these circuits. Okay, so let me start. For both the circuits, input is U of T. For both the circuits, output is UI of T. Okay, in state space analysis, we make the input as U, output as Y. States as given as X of T. We have already discussed these things in the first and part 1, part 2 of the state space analysis lecture. Those who have not seen this lecture, please visit the video in the channel, Fundamentals Learner. Okay, now you see, this is your X of T. Right? Observe closely. Let me say the current flowing through this is I. The current flowing through this arm is I by 2. This is also I by 2, equally divided. The reason is, though the capacity is physically present, it is technically absent because it's a balanced bridge circuit, right? When you multiply the opposite resistance, you get the equal values. So the potential at these two points are equal. Okay, that means no current will flow through this capacitor. So these 2 ohms and 2 ohms and these 2 ohms and 2 ohms will act as if they are in series. Okay, so when 2 and 2 are in series, it becomes it becomes 4, right? And this also becomes 4. Okay. Since these two points are the same potential, these 2 ohms and 2 ohms are in parallel. They can go that way also, right? Since the potential, since it's a balanced bridge, the voltage at these two points are equal. So this is a short circuit, acts as if in short circuit. So 2 ohms and 2 ohms are in parallel. So it becomes 1 ohm. 2 ohms and 2 ohms are in parallel becomes 1 ohm. Okay. Now, what is the current flowing? Still, the current flowing through this is I. The current flowing through this branch is I. Okay, right. But you see, physically looking, these two circuits are entirely different, right? But concept-wise, they are functioning in the same way. What I say physically they are same means, by looking from the input and output point of view, the circuit is the same. But if you look the internally, it is not the same. Okay, state space analysis gives an idea how it is functioning inside. By looking at the states. Okay. Right. Is it clear for you? These two circuits, from you look U and Y, here U and Y, it is the same. But internally, it's functioning differently. Right. With this in mind, we move into the next topic. That's controllability and observability. Okay. This is the statement for controllability. Controllability is of two types. One is state controllable. Another is output controllable. Okay. Mostly state controllable is what asked. And the output controllable, I will give the definition, right? Okay. A system is said to be completely state controllable at time t naught if it is possible by means of unconstrained control vector U of t to transfer the system from initial state x of t naught to any other desired state at finite interval of time. Okay. The definition may be looking a bit difficult, but you can look it very closely here. Let me say state I represented by x of t. Initially, I am saying the system is in what state at time t naught? State is x t naught. Okay. If it is completely controllable for input, I am going to give the input. Input is U of t. Okay. If I give the input U of t, what happens? It will go from the state x of t naught to any state x of t. Right? That is the statement, right? Completely controllable at time t naught if it is possible by means of unconstrained control vector. Control vector is your input, right? I give the input to transfer the system from initial state x of t naught to any other desired state in finite interval of time. What they mean? This state can be controlled. They mean is this state in the sense x can be controlled, right? Initially is a t naught. I am giving a controlled vector. This is a input, right? I am giving the input U of t. By giving the input, what I am doing? I am transferring the state to some other state x of t within a finite interval of time. If I can do that, it is completely state controllable. Now look at this simple block diagram. This will convey an it will convey a very good idea for you. Okay, let me say this is the system, right? Here I have the output, this is the input, output and input. Now we observe see what are the states present. X1 is one state, X2 is another state. We have already seen in part 2 of the lecture, of part 1 also, how to select a state variable. It is a number of memory storage elements, right? If the system is having two memory storage elements, I put the state variable as X1 and X2. Look, this X1 is controlled by U of T, right? And it is going to the output. Similarly, look at X2. X2 is not connected to input, right? It is not connected to input, but it is influencing or changing X1 and is also changing output, right? So this X2 is uncontrollable. This is an example for uncontrollable, right? X1 is controllable. X1 is controllable by the input U of T, but X2 is uncontrollable. So it is uncontrollable and state is uncontrollable. Okay, this is an example. Now come to the observability, right? In observability, what we do is a system is said to be observable, right? At any time t naught, if at time t naught, if the system is in state x t naught, if it is possible to determine this state from the observation of the output over the finite interval of time. Okay, simple. I have some states, that's, I can take the same example, like I have a state x of t naught. Okay. I can observe it at the output, right? Now what is happening, after some time it is changing, okay, to some state x of t. If this is also seen by the output or observed by the output, then I say it is completely observable, right? Simple, go by the meaning. States are controllable. States are controllable, if you look at this, states are controllable by the input. States are observed by the output. Is it okay? Control is by the input, observation is by the output. Okay, right. Now look at this block diagram. If you look at this block diagram, okay, this is the block, right? So here we have the output, here we have the input. Look here, how many states are there? X1 is a state, X2 is a state. But X1, you can observe at X, observe the output Y of T. But X2 is not observable. Look here, it is coming to the input. It is X1's output is coming as input X2, but its output is not going to the output, right? X2's output is not observed by the output. So it is not observable. Is it okay? Right. Fine. So again, I repeat, for controllability means state controllability is there. State controllability means if I can control the state by the input. That means if I can control the state by the input, I can say it is state controllable. This block diagram gives a perfect idea, right? If you look at this state, input is connected. If you look at this state, input is not connected. So this is not controllable, state controllable. What is observability? I have to observe the state by from the output, right? X1 can be observed from the output, but X2 is not connected to the output, so it cannot be observed. So this is not observable. Okay, this in mind, we move to the next one, next content. The definition for state controllable means I can find it out using forming this matrix, right? B, A, B, A square B, A power n minus 1 B. Okay, what is the state vector? State vector is n cross 1, right? We know what is n. N is a number of memory elements. Okay, if we form the matrix S matrix, okay, first row, first column is B, second column is AB, third column is A square B, right, and up to A power n minus 1 B. If that rank is equal to n, then I mean it is state controllable. It means state controllable. Okay, now let me take an example. I have three variables, right? Three state variables. So it is 3 cross 1. So what should be the matrix? B, A, B, n is 3. Okay, so it is up to A square B, right? So the rank should be equal to 3 for the system to be state controllable. Okay, right. Now there is another definition called output controllable. What we say output controllable is output can be controlled by the input. We say it is output controllable, right? Okay, for this what I do, I take CB, CAB, CA square B, CA power n minus 1 B and D, where M is the number of outputs. Okay, if I find the rank of this, and if it is equal to N, if the rank is M, then it is output controllable, right? For state controllable, we look at the number of states, N. For output controllable, we look at the number of outputs, M. Okay, if the ranks of this matrix is equal to N, means I say it is state controllable. If the rank of this matrix is equal to M, means I say it is output controllable, right? Okay, we take a simple problem. Some state equation is given, right? Okay, they are asking whether it is state controllable or not. This is your A, this is your B. Okay, this is x, standard form is x dot AB. What is expression? This is your x dot equal to AX plus BU, right? So this is your A, this is your B. What about you? I wrote the A and B. So how many state variables are there? 3 state variables are there. So N is equal to 3. Okay, so the expression becomes, matrix becomes S equal to B, A, B, A square B. Now we know what is B, fill it here, 0, 0, 1. What is A, B? Multiply A into B. A is there, B is there, you multiply. Then A square B, find out A square, multiply with B, you get this, you fill it here. Thereby you can solve for S. That is another way, instead of finding out A square, what you do is, if you have A, B, right, if you have A, B, what you can do? I have A, B, so I put A here. So A into A, B, because A, B already I found out. This is equal to A square B. So instead of finding A square and then multiplying with B, what you can do? Just you multiply A, B with A, put A before, then A, B next to it. Then you multiply, then also you will get the same answer, 1, minus 3 and 7. Now find out the rank of this matrix. Yes, I will find the determinant, right? The determinant I should get, it should not be equal to 0, right? On solving I get it's minus 1, so minus 1 is not equal to 0. So the rank of the determinant is 3, so the state variable is also 3, so the system is completely state controllable. Okay. Next, we move into observability. For observability, what you take is C transpose, A transpose, C transpose, A transpose up to N minus 1 C transpose, right? If the rank is N, if the rank of S0 is N, then I say the system is completely observable. Okay, here a state space model is given, A is given, B is given, C is given. First thing, find out the number of variables. How to find the number of variables? Number of variables can be found out from the A matrix, right? What is A matrix? A matrix is definitely a square matrix, right? So it should be like 2 cross 2 or 3 cross 2. If it is 2 cross 2, based on A, I say N is equal to 2, right? Then what is the definition? How to find out the observability? C transpose, A transpose, C transpose. Is N equal to 2, I have to put up to N minus 1. So 2 minus 1, I have to stop C transpose and A transpose, C transpose, okay? So C transpose is, you have to change the rows into column, right? That's your transpose operation. So 1, 0 becomes 1 and here in the column wise it is 0. So multiply A transpose and C transpose, take A transpose, C transpose, multiply, you get minus 2 and 0. If you take the determinant, it is becoming 0. It is not, rank is not equal to 2. So the system is not observable, right? It's not an observable system. Okay, I ask you to take few practice problems before that. This is practice problems. Look, and A is given, B is given, C is given. They are asking check for observability. How will check for observability? C transpose. Since what is the rank of this? Rank of this is not rank. It's an n order is equal to, this is n cross n matrix is equal to 3 cross 3, right? For observable, you should form a matrix, that is your S0 matrix. S0 is equal to C transpose, A transpose, C transpose, then A transpose power n minus 1. So A transpose square C transpose. Okay. So substitute the values of C transpose, A transpose, C transpose, A transpose square and C transpose. You find out the determinant of it, right? That will be, I give a solution, it is not observable because the rank you will be getting is 2. Okay, we will get the determinant as 0. Okay, it's not equal to 3, so it is not observable. Then another practice problem, here A, B, C are given. They are asking, find the state controllability, output controllability and observability. Okay, for state controllability, we have to use the expression B, A, B. For output controllability, C, B, C, A, B. For observability, C transpose, A transpose, C transpose, right? Okay. For output controllability, very important thing, for output controllability, we have to take the number of outputs. For state controllability, we have to find the number of states. If the ranks are equal, then we say it is completely state controllable, it is completely output controllable. If the rank is equal to 2, we say it is completely state observable. Okay. Remember, for this problem, we will be getting the rank as 2, 1 and 2. So the system is all are, it's completely state controllable, completely observable, sorry, completely output controllable, completely observable. Okay, you can verify the answer. If you have any doubts and queries, please put in the comment section. I'm always ready to help you. Thanks for listening. Happy learning. Thank you.